In the end, we will conserve only what we love. We will love only what we understand, and we'll understand only what we are taught. And so I think that really makes sense, because you don't care about something unless you understand the value in it or the importance of it.
Hi, I'm Payton Zolck, and welcome to the first episode of Living with Mother Earth. This is a documentary series where we'll be going over different environmental issues as well as the climate crisis. In each episode, we will talk to experts on their opinions regarding these different issues as well as specific problems and solutions. In this first episode, we are looking at our school and the different environmental problems and solutions that are going on, as well as some of the people on our campus's opinions.
I think personally that education in all issues is really important to me, because the only way to know how you feel about an issue is if you're educated about it. And I think that's especially true for climate change, because one of the main problems that we face as climate activists is sort of the ignorance.
I think in general, whenever you take a course or whenever you learn about something, I think it resonates with people in different ways. And so some people get inspired just personally. Some people become inspired to, speak about it or to research more into it, or maybe they discover an animal or plant that they're really passionate about and look into its conservation. So I think it really depends on the student and how different ideas and topics resonate with them. So I hope that, by learning about the environment and how it touches literally every single one of us, I'm hoping that people will use their individual unique strengths to leverage, things that they can do, whether it's speaking out and educating other people or starting an initiative on campus.
Awareness is an important part of combating environmental issues, but action is the next step. There are many things as an individual and a school that we can do.
Our campus doesn't sell plastic water bottles in the vending machines. And in terms of transportation, I think there's a good amount of students who take the bus, carpool, bike, or walk. The drive-in system consists of a trash, recycling, and compost bin, and this makes it easier for students to easily sort their waste into three different categories.
Things like going to strikes, that's another way that we can sort of unite.
Our campus is not perfect, and there are still various environmental problems that need to be addressed.
I do think that lack of education or knowledge about the issue is a really big one on our campus. We've actually been really surprised with how many people, don't really understand either the specifics of the issue or how serious it is and is going to become, or how it relates to other issues that they might be interested in.
Another issue is that we don't have an AP environmental science class. And in a time where we're having an environmental crisis, educating ourselves on this topic is super important. And I think it would also be a good way to attract students to environmental careers.
I think that if you find other people with your interests and, work together to create change, then you're not just one person anymore. You're hundreds or thousands of people. And then, you can really make your voice heard.
The more you get people to care, the more action gets done.
I'm Payton Zolck, reporting for Scott Center News, and keep checking Scott Center for more episodes to come.